Welcome to the new learning experience. It is a model to positively influence society to improve the visibility and traceability of learning at work, including knowledge or peripheral competencies. Learning, as traditionally defined, is the process of acquiring knowledge or skill. In the current state of society, we categorize learning into three separate areas: academic or traditional learning institutions. These areas consist of institutions such as primary education, vocational training, college or university, and others, like continuing education. Then we learn work and professional settings, such as training centers, mentorship projects, and on-the-job training. Finally, there is social and personal learning, and these include family, including pre-kindergarten, community, clubs, and special interest groups. In the present state, there are quite rigid boundaries between these areas. However, loose connections in between academic learning and work-based learning do exist, such as professional societies, conferences, recruitment, and collaborative research. Also, there are the central institutions, such as governmental agencies and incubators, that provide a link, rules, and guidance to all three sectors. This model is stagnant and institution-centered at its core. Our belief that a fundamental shift is required to take the individual into account and to nurture it. Then the social, professional, and academic sectors fall in place in relation to the individual in a life cycle context. What makes the model so powerful is that, with the individual of the center, individuals are empowered to discover, shape, and define learning in a way that is personalized. It is supportive of who we are and what we want to achieve. We split the life of an individual according to the 8 human development stages. These can be grouped into 3 stages in the context of learning. From the ages of 0 to 7, learning is dominated by the social or personal area. Work-based and academic learning has a minimal impact here. Then between the ages of 7 to 20, individuals are required to go through a mandatory education which increases the influence of the academic area to dominate the personal area. From 20 years forward, the individuals enter the work phase of life, where work becomes the dominant area. While our case focuses primarily on work-based learning, we cannot ignore the rest of the life cycle. We believe that tremendous potential lies in the collective synergy and power of aligning these three separate areas of learning. To do this, we must look at learning as a continuum that changes as time progresses. Within each stage of development, there is a clear single dominance of learning in one sector, with little or no connection to the others. We observed a rather discrete jump in between each stage and believe that this creates a chasm, where the experience from one stage is not carried over to the next. As a result, we rely upon institutions such as accreditation and credentials to judge how qualified we are to move and make the transition. Then we asked ourselves, how can we possibly change the situation to be more organic, natural, and personalized? We started with some keywords like balance, collaboration, synergy, transitions, as are these we wanted to prototype. From there, we envisioned how things can change and came up with a new model themed upon the idea of connections and interactions. Instead of discrete jumps in between stages, we envisioned smooth transitions. To achieve this, we needed to reduce the single dominance and enhance the influence of weaker sectors in each stage. In practice, this means that work-based learning methodologies, perpetrating into mandatory education at an earlier stage and wider scale, as well as academia connections being stronger in the traditional workplace. Eventually, the idea is that there would exist such great collaboration and balance between the three sectors that the synergy would bind them together. What we envisioned is that these synergetic forces will be so strong that the sectors would overlap in such a way that the distinction between the three separate circles would be irrelevant. And we can create one holistic cloud of continuous lifelong learning. Thank you.